Other stocks in Asia reversed earlier gains, dragged down by declines in Chinese markets, which were jolted by a new round of sanctions from the West. Investors now awaiting the congressional appearance by U.S. Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell and Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen. Taking a look now at major stock indices in Asia, all are in the red except Singapore's Straits Times Index, which is posting modest gains. Over in Europe, futures are all down, with the CAC 40 leading the losses, down by 0.9%. Meanwhile, Wall Street is poised for a lower open. All futures are also down, despite Monday's gains led by a tech rebound. Back here at home, Philippine shares snapped their two-day losing streak. The main index now back above the 6,400 level after gaining 0.8%. First Resources Management says the surge may be a classic case of a possible dead cat bounce. It adds another reason could be the listing of DDMP tomorrow. As for Aaron Say of First Metro Securities, he believes the market could be headed lower.
Based on valuation, again, the EPS that we are seeing now, the forward EPS that we are seeing now, is actually expecting 23% growth from last year. No, if the situation linger, I think there could be some re-rating lower. No, if it goes lower, then definitely valuation would be rich as where we are now. Chart-wise, it might actually fall to around 5,700, wow. I think, at the very least.